Welcome back to Nightcast. For a year now, you've seen her face. She's been on our TV screens as we listen to the latest COVID-19 updates provided by the state. We're talking about sign language interpreter Nic Zapko. And today, on her birthday, she received a very special surprise recognition.
There's been somebody who's been here since the beginning, ensuring that every single Minnesotan had access to this information in real time. That person is by far the most popular person on this podium and the most well-known of that. So I would like to make a proclamation today for Nic Zapko, our interpreter, who we've all come to really appreciate and enjoy, and who is totally unaware I was going to do this. Yay.
As she signs along flawlessly, the governor declared today Nic Zapko Day in Minnesota. So who is she, and how did she end up with this role? Tonight, Ben Henry caught up with her.
First off, of course, happy birthday. How was the day?
It was good. It was an amazing day, an amazing birthday.
Before we learn how amazing it was, let's start with how Nic Zapko's work is even possible.
The whole team is here. Let's talk a little bit about how the team works.
The hearing team, which is Patty here, sits just under the camera and is in direct line with me. So I stand next to the presenter, the speaker, whoever's talking, and I watch Patty. She delivers that information to me.
There's Zapko, in a normal spot next to Governor Walz, and then in front, with her back to us, is Patty McCutcheon. Seen here, top left, speaking for Zapko, who has been deaf her entire life.
Patty's responsible for taking in the information in her first language, English, processing it, then delivering it to me, in which I can then process it and put it into my native language for a wide variety in my community.
The team has been through a lot, alongside Governor Walz and health officials from the start of the pandemic through last summer's unrest.
The good news is to be seeing this now at a point where we're controlling our destiny.
To now, sharing and communicating positive news about better days ahead.
I feel honored and thrilled to be able to provide that kind of access in this language. It's so important for our community, the deaf, deafblind, and hard of hearing community, to be able to see their language received there right in the moment from the governor of the state, in particular about COVID-19 and all the times when people are afraid and worried.
Through that solid teamwork and one-of-a-kind expressions, which Zapko says is critical when communicating, today was possible.
I, Tim Walz, the governor of Minnesota, do hereby proclaim Tuesday, March 9th, 2021, as Nic Zapko Day.
Talk about that.
Yay.
When the governor made his proclamation.
Congratulations.
Totally unexpected. Amazing. Really, I was in shock. At the same time, I tried to my best to stay and roll and finish the message about me, of all things. And inside, I'm thinking, oh my God, are you talking about me? I mean, there was this shock component too, but I kept interpreting at the same time, processing. And then after all day, just thinking about it. It's a surprise, but also an incredible honor for me and just inspiring for me to see this successful recognition of our language and our access.
Very special lady, special day too. Zapko says as much of an honor as it's been for her, she knows this recognition will help the deaf community. And Lindsay, Patty McCutcheon, the other part of the hearing team, says she echoes Zapko's message and that they've been able to develop quite a flow.
Well, obviously so. Let's talk more about Patty. Why is it so important that there are two of them?
That's right. Simply put, it's Zapko's ability to use expressions while communicating. Not to say McCutcheon couldn't, Patty there, but the sign language is Zapko's native language, as she puts it. Like any language, there are barriers and cultural components. Zapko knows how to best relay those messages. And Lindsay, her ability to use expressions so well is why so many people have appreciated the work that she does.
She's been there the entire time.
Yeah,
thank you,
true.
Ben, yeah. And happy birthday to Nic Zapko.